THX-1138.
Two of the new generation of film men, Francis Coppola and George Lucas, are discussing director Lucas' new movie, THX-1138. In particular, they touch on the demands a production can make on those involved.
George, where did the very first idea of Thex come to you?
It actually came from reading comic books when I was about 10 years old. And I was always struck with the fact that we were living in the future. If you were to make a film about the future, the way to do it would be to use real things, because we are living in the future. Everything is removed from reality. Everything is like third hand in the society. Everything is via television or via intercom. You know, no communication between people and distance and all electrical. It's a contemporary story. It's about today. And therefore, I want to make it out of existing things so that everything there is real, only altered slightly in order to give it a kind of alien look.
George, tell me, how are you going to, like, realize this world? It's a world that doesn't exist. You know, what are you going to see? If it takes place in the future, where are we going to shoot it?
I have this great idea about shaving everybody's heads.
They all have their head shaved?
Yes.
Girls?
Yes.
How are you going to get girls to have no hair?
Well, you know, it's not that unusual a thing. I mean, girls do cut their hair.
How are you going to ask some beautiful girl with long, beautiful hair to shave off all her hair? She's never going to do it.
I like my hair. I know other people like my hair.
Walter, did George tell you his new idea? What do you think about shaving the heads of all the people?
I don't know, Francis. A lot is going to ride on the appearance of the star, you know, the major character. Shave DeVal or something and he looks terrible. You're stuck with it.
Who are you?
I'm a hologram. I'm not real. You know, the Fantasy Bureau have electrically generated realities and all that.
Hey, look.
You are engaged in an unauthorized procedure. Remain where you are. This...
We have a U-65 on a K-8.
This is 91021 on case 918. We are going to need assistance. This is an electronic restricted area. It would be nice to have three additional offices.
Going to the guillotine. I had the last few minutes left.
Sitting at the counter at the health food store eating my carrot raisin salad. And you walked in and you asked me if I wanted to be a movie star. Remember? And you told me that they wanted me to do the part. That certainly will be one of the most vivid memories of my lifetime. The excitement of having the part, knowing I had it, overwhelmed me. So much the fact that I was getting my hair cut off was sort of secondary. But it was in the back of my mind, of course. I look to it as an adventure. There's not many really far-out things one can do in a lifetime. And getting your hair cut off for a film, I think would be a very unusual thing.
I thought this morning, though, as soon as it comes off, you know, I can just yell to my wife 3,000 miles away. It's like forced fidelity. It could be a little farcical. The acting is really sketchy. You know, if it's sketchy, sort of, not really human, then they'll say, oh, it's interesting for all people, another kind of gimmick. I think it could be terrific because those sets, I've never seen sets like that. If the acting sort of matches the visual thing, I think it could really be exciting.
Are you all right? What did they do to you?
I'm going to have a child.
Every once in a while, during those last 2 days, I would stop and think and wonder how I would... how it would be. Oh. Oh, wow.
everyone just running their fingers through your hair. It's such a good tactile feeling, and it's terrible.
Sounds like crickets. There's a hunter here.
Oh. Maybe it doesn't look so bad.
It'll be fun to see people's reactions. It's one of the things I'm looking forward to about it. Yeah, it's an experience. At least it's, I didn't lose an arm.
Ooh, very soothing.
I feel very differently now than when you first started it. It's really strange. I feel like I have something special. Oh, how crazy.
You know what I want? I want ideas. I want one idea.
One idea could get us out of here.
I wouldn't protest against dandruff. My head feels a lot lighter. Oh, such a blade.
Oh, wow. You're really cutting it close. You know something? I'm really getting angry.
Be sure. Straightforward and plain as the nose on your face.
Oh, I can't. I really cannot believe this whole feeling. Because in some ways I really like it.
When the hair finally started coming off and you saw it was going through, did you kind of think...
I had my moments when it was coming off, I'll tell you. It was a traumatic experience.
I can't open my eyes. I just can't do it. I can't.
Really, I felt very sorry and very bad when it was actually happening, and I'm thinking to myself, you know, what have I done? But I got over it quicker than they did.
I've been watching it.
No one knows.
They're watching us now.
No one can see us.